Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi. Hi.
Laura.
Hi. Nice to meet you.
How are you doing?
Piglet.
Piglet.
Really?
Yep.
Okay.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah.
How are you doing?
Hello. Nice to meet you. Yeah.
Well, look, thanks for having us. I'd love to have a look around.
No problem.
Absolutely.
Especially as the train there as well.
Yeah. Come on through.
So the place looks incredibly original. I love it.
Yeah.
It's literally been transported back in time. Absolutely. I think this is one of the best we've seen, isn't it, T?
Yeah.
It's incredible. You can see the odd piece, which has been changed, but apart from that, it's amazing. The railway station is incredible. It's really romantic, enigmatic, beautiful. The light in here is something else. It's incredible. The condition of everything I'm seeing is just so perfect, so spot on colour-wise. The originality just blows me away. I love places like this.
Laura and Piglet are taking Drew to start in one of the storerooms just across from the station itself.
So, stores.
Yeah. Do you want to go upstairs?
Yes, please. Oh, blimey. Wow. All those signs. You're not going to get rid of those, are you?
There's plenty to be looking through.
Yeah, I'll take all of it. With anything that comes out of railways, or railway arna is actually a thing in the antiques world, it tends to be extremely good quality. There's all sorts, really. There's collectors for anything to do with trains. They're really sort of avid, massive, huge collectors. That's the obvious one there. Station clock tea. Can you cut that? Was Piglet.
Absolutely, yeah, I've got it.
Is it a gents one?
Smith's.
Smith's Electric.
Smith's Electric.
Double-sided. Would have been the master clock, that one by the looks of it. Is that for sale?
Yes.
It is?
Yeah, I think
you're not using it?
No, it's not in use at the moment, though.
I think this is a master clock. This would have hung in the station or in one of the small anterooms or who knows, but it's from a station.
A station's master clock is how the other slave clocks are synchronised. From the mid-19th century, master clocks would be set using Greenwich Mean Time, which was received via electronic pulses. Before this, trains ran to local time, which became increasingly problematic as the railways grew. This 1930s master clock, made by 19th century company Smiths, could be worth around £900 once it's working again.
Ballpark figure, what do you want for it? I'm trying to think what I can pay for it.
I'm looking at about £250.
Yeah.
Deal.
Sold.
Keen to collect as much railway memorabilia as he can, Drew's not stopping there.
But these signs, though, aren't these from the station themselves?
They're not specifically from this line. Obviously, if it's got a station name on it, then that's where it came from, which have limited use here.
That one. Look at that colour.
I know, it's
fabulous. Nice. Like a baked bean, untouched.
Untouched.
Love that. Whenever I get the opportunity to buy railway signage, I always do. It sells very, very well. They go everywhere. You can have them in shops. They'll look good in pubs, restaurants, or in your house. That's why I really like buying them, because there's loads of different people that can buy them off you for loads of different reasons. It's not niche at all.
Throughout the 20th century, railway signs and buildings were typically painted in colours to denote the train company running the line. The London and North Eastern Railway, who operated this line, used mostly green and cream after 1936, but would use bold, brighter colours for hazard or exit signs like this one. It's from around the 1950s, is in good condition, and after a clean, could be worth around £300.
Do you have a price for that one?
£150?
Yes.
OK.
Fair.
Deal.
Yours. Nice and heavy.
Two deals done, and Drew's on a roll.
£50?
Yeah, I'll take 50.
Yeah.
It's a deal.
That's a cracking sign.
Toilet sign.
Always go well, these.
Yeah.
Whenever we get one, they always sell straight away.
But you've just hung yourself by saying it goes.
Well, eventually, you know, they'd...
Yeah, don't try and get out of it now.
What do you want for that one? I'll give you £100 for it.
Yeah.
OK, £100.
Not fair.
Yeah, yeah, that's fine.
We're too fat for this. Too fat and too old. Got that one. 60.
75.
Okay. Yeah.
Deal.
We'll have that one.
Yeah.
Right, now we've got to get it down there.
Nah, yeah.
With two floors of items here, Drew wants to make sure he doesn't miss out on any other deals downstairs.
T?
Yeah.
You feeling adventurous?
Always.
Oh, look at him go.
Like a gazelle.
I was going to say.
It's the look I've been going for, actually.
Cool. Love it. £75 for the last one. Same again?
Yeah, I think we can do a deal like that. Yep, no problem.
Marvellous. These signs generally were inside the station, underneath canopies, and hanging from chains or attached to walls. So they never got touched, they never got damaged, and what's really good about these, they haven't been repainted. The patina and the sort of wear on that paint, and it's old enamel paint as well, it's just great. It sets them off.
Drew's bought five signs, and Laura and Piglet also want him to check out the engine sheds near the station of Grosmont, about half an hour away. It was one of the stations along this line that was used in the Harry Potter films, and it's at Grosmont that the line's historic engines are maintained. They head into the storage areas, where Drew hopes to find more items.
I'm open to offers on the lamps.
These are of interest to me, because they're already on a mount.
Yeah.
Absolutely, yeah.
These are work lights that you would have out. Generally, they were used for when people were digging out in the roads and things like that. Now, these are gas-powered lights, but it's just all about the patina, you know? It's all about the patina, the colour, and just whether or not I think they're cool or not.
These mid-20th century industrial lights are made by British manufacturers Bullfinch. Their lamps were very common for use in road building, factories, and even with the army. These examples, once rewired, polished, and remounted, could be worth around £500 each.
What do you want from?
£75 each. Nice. Got a deal.
Sold. That's spot on. No, fab. Fine.
Yep, you can
fine.
Have them for £20.
Oh.
Really? Oh.
Each, maybe. Yeah.
I'll take it for £20 each just for the parts.
Excellent.
Right.
Drew spent £890. Now Laura and Piglet want to take Drew to the workshop to show him another crucial element of what they do here.
Blimey. Look at that.
Thank you.
Yeah, this is our engineering workshop where we restore the locomotives.
Amazing. My God. I mean, I know this happens, but until you see it, it's sort of...
It's quite large scale,
it's quite large scale. Look at the size of that thing.
We've been to loads of engineering works over the years, but this is the daddy. We've not seen anything like this. It's major, major league stuff. I mean, look at the size of these things. It's huge.
A team of specialists and enthusiasts ensure that these giant pieces of history are kept in perfect working order.
I used to be able to weld.
Yeah, well, we can find out if you'd like.
Yeah, I'd love to.
Yeah, do you want to walk this way?
Yes, please.
Drew used to weld car frames, but that was almost 30 years ago. Now they're letting him loose on a locomotive ash pan.
If you'd like to have a go with the arc welder, and welders that seam up there.
Yeah. They've let me have a go at welding. I love welding. And I've just remembered that I wasn't very good at it.
Has he balled it up yet?
Oh, dear Lord, that's terrible. My welding today was terrible. There was nothing good about it at all. There's no redeeming aspect to the whole thing. It was a disaster.
First attempt, it's not too bad. You started to get the hang of it up here. It just takes a lot of practice. Yeah, it comes back to you. But yeah,
I got that. There's a good bit there.
Yeah, there's a good 2-inch section in the middle. Yeah.
That's all you need.
It's not too bad.
Does the cat weld better than that?
I think there's pigeons nesting.
I want to carry on. I want to weld something else now.
Yeah, well, there's a big boiler behind you there.
Don't talk to him about that like that. Today was thoroughly enjoyable. The restoration and the authenticity inside the station itself is quite incredible. It's an amazing example of it. I've not seen one as good. All in all, good items, you know, happy to come here. But for me, the best thing was seeing that station with the smoke in the light and then coming into the restoration workshop and seeing the standard of work in here, which is incredibly high. I don't think I'll be getting a job as a welder, though.